Hello, 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 and welcome to day two. It's still a ride. some janitorial bits. Once again, we will have breakout sessions at the end. You're more than welcome to join those. If you go to the left hand of the Kiko chat thing, there you see the different topics. And you can just join and click the upper left green button, ideally exiting the other stream first, and just join to discuss any topics. If you want to have other rooms or other topics, you can also just suggest those in #promcon on CNCF Slack, which brings us to the next point. There is the CNC Slack, and #promcon exists for all your needs. And also, as per usual, there is an announcement doc in case anything goes wrong. You can just go there and we can regroup. But everything worked really nicely yesterday, so I don't think we'll have any issues. All that being said, let's introduce Julian Pivotto, Prometheus team member and dedicated to the cause. And he'll be talking about TLS within Prometheus. I would ask everyone to clap at home.
Hello everyone, I am Julien Pivotto, and today I will present you about Prometheus and TLS, and especially the latest changes that have come to the node exporter, which now supports TLS natively. So the Prometheus server has supported TLS for a long time, at least as a client, and now we are bringing that to the exporters and the other components of the Prometheus ecosystem, which acts as servers. As you know, Prometheus is pool-based and works over HTTP, and basically nowadays TLS is basically the default for HTTP in many areas, and now the Prometheus project is taking over with the help of the community to enable native TLS support inside the Prometheus ecosystem. We'll also see what will come next, and we will have a few demos during this talk. So as I said, it was possible to do TLS before, but it included external components now, like Nginx or another reverse proxies. Now you can do that natively with the node exporter. So I am Julien Pivotto. I am streaming from Belgium. I am an open source consultant at Inuit, which is an European open source company where we do consultancy. And I am basically part of the Prometheus team working on the Prometheus server more specifically. So the setup that we will use today for the demo is a simple setup with two different servers. So we have one Prometheus server, and that Prometheus server is configured to monitor a second server which only contains a node exporter. So the second server is just a node exporter deployed there, and currently, as you can see, I will make that bigger. Prometheus is scraping the metrics over plain HTTP, which means that as this is a public IP address for the moment, everyone else can scrape those metrics if they want, which is not ideal for multiple reasons. And that's why today we will show how TLS authentication works for the node exporter. So here is our node exporter. It exposes the metrics of the machines over HTTP. And basically every 30 seconds or every minute, Prometheus will come and will scrape those metrics and store them in its time series database. So this is plain HTTP, which means that on one hand, it's very easy to debug. To when you have a server in a failing state, you can just go to the server and do a curl and see the metrics directly. On the other hand, when it is exposed on public interfaces or even an internet network, anyone can see the metrics, which can be an issue, and we will see why in a few seconds. So why would you want TLS? Well, basically TLS first, it's now the default in many situations. So why wouldn't you want TLS? That's more the question. Even it makes the setup a bit more complex, it's in most situations it's worth it. So There are two things you can do with TLS. First of all, you can just encrypt the traffic, which means that you will not have any plain text over the wire anymore. So everything will be encrypted between the server and the node exporter, which means that if someone is snooping on the line, they will not be able to see your metrics. Note that with the primitive security model, the metrics are not considered secret, but still, in some cases, you don't want anyone to be able to see your metrics. The second part, which is very important also, is the authentication. What it means is that with TLS, you will be able to verify first that the Prometheus server is monitoring the correct target, so it will authenticate the target, it will authenticate the host name, that it gets the metrics for the actual node exporter on that server. And the second thing is that the node exporter itself will be able to authenticate the Prometheus server. So if you use, for example, a client certificate, you will be able to authenticate that yes, that request is valid, it's coming from the Prometheus server. Why is that important? It's important because some exporters, like the node exporter, but also like the SNMP exporter, they do a lot of different things and that can put some pressures on the system. So if you think about the SNMP exporter, we have some old switches where basically if you query multiple times the SNMP metrics, you will get devices that are overloaded. So in that case, it is very useful to be able to authenticate that only Prometheus is doing the query. So that's why we will demonstrate today how we can ensure that it is my Prometheus server that's monitoring the exporter and how the exporter can make sure that it is monitoring the right target and that no one else can monitor that target. Let's start with encrypting the traffic, which means that we will make the traffic between the node exporter and the Prometheus server encrypted with TLS. It means that we will, for the first step, just make sure that we don't have any plain text lying on the network. So if you listen to the network traffic, you will not be able to see the metrics going on. We will not do any verification of certificates for the moment. We will just start simple, just setting TLS on the node exporter and setting up TLS client on the Prometheus server. You know, Prometheus is pool-based, so it is always Prometheus, which will pool the metrics for other systems. So my Prometheus system is currently pulling metrics over HTTP, and to make it use HTTPS, I have two solutions. The first solution is to configure HTTPS at the job level, which means that all the targets of the same job will be using HTTPS. The second option is a more advanced feature, is to use the relabeling and to change the label underscore scheme to HTTPS, and so only a few targets will switch to HTTPS in a given job. For this setup today, I will just change the variable of the job itself, so all my nodes, I only have one in this case, will be moved to HTTPS. You can see that in the configuration too. So if I look at the configuration too for my node, I see that I have a scheme which is set to HTTP and which I will now change to HTTPS. It is a default value. It is not in the file now. I will just add it and reload the Prometheus configuration. I don't need to restart Prometheus to apply the configuration. I can just send a SIGUP signal to the process and it will take up the configuration. When I will have done that part, then it means that my target will be seen as done because I have not configured the node exporter yet to accept HTTPS. So Prometheus will talk HTTPS to an HTTP server, which will fail. So here is my Prometheus configuration file, and I have my job, which does not have the scheme parameter yet. So I will just add it. And because I have said that for the moment, I will not take care about authenticating the server for this first step, I will just add a TLS configuration, which will be insecure skip verify true. No. Something like this should work. I will see that now. I will reload the configuration. And we will see if that has worked. So yes, I see now that I have my scheme set to HTTPS and I see my TLS configuration insecure skip verify true, which means that we will not care about the SSL certificate on the other end of the connection. So now if I go to my target, I see now that it is trying to use HTTPS to connect to the node exporter, but the node exporter itself did give an HTTP answer to my HTTPS client, which does not work obviously. So now let's see how we can configure the node exporter to serve HTTPS. We will now generate a node exporter certificate, so the certificate that will be used to encrypt the traffic between the Prometheus server and the node exporter. In this example, we will use what is called a self-signed certificate, which means that the same certificate will be used as the certificate authority and the certificate for the server. In a real world, you will usually use a certificate authority which is public, like Let's Encrypt or another one, or you can use your enterprise certificate authority to issue certificates so that you only need to trust one certificate for all your exporters. For this example, just simple OpenSSL commands. There are other tools to help you doing that kind of self CA, like EasyRSA from OpenVPN or CFSSL from Cloudflare. So let's generate a certificate for my node exporter. I have prepared that OpenSSL command to generate a 1 year certificate and key that will contain the IP addresses IPv4, IPv6 of my node exporter. So when I generate the command, I basically have two files, one which should stay on that server, which is the .key file, the key of my node exporter used to encrypt the traffic and to encrypt the traffic, and the CRT file which should be used to authenticate the traffic, that the traffic is really coming from my node exporter. So the .crt file, as you can see, it is readable by all the users, so it is a public file. Let's say it like that, but the key should be private and should be kept on the node exporter server itself and should not be moved away. So now I need to tell the node exporter to use that certificate and that key. How can I do that? Let's see on the node exporter documentation how to do that. So when I go to the node exporter documentation, I can go to the HTTPS part of the node exporter on GitHub, and then I will see the small documentation that is there. So the documentation will probably be moved in the future, but for the moment you will find it in the node exporter GitHub repository itself. So I can see that I have a bunch of parameters that I can configure on the node exporter itself. The good news is that almost all of them can be changed on the fly. So for example, if you want to change the certificates, if you want to change the users that we will see the users later, all of that you can just enable and disable them on the fly. The only thing that you cannot change on the fly will be enable or disable TLS. That is a choice that you make when you start the server and you cannot undo that. So let's create a file. So this is a dedicated configuration file that will be read upon every request so that Prometheus will pick the correct certificate, the correct files, etc. So I create a web.yaml file, TLS server config, and I will just put the mandatory parameter, which is cert file, certificate file, which is node exporter.crt, so it is the file that we have seen just 1 minute ago, and the key file, which is the node exporter.key. Here we go. So I have created the minimum a configuration file for my node exporter to use TLS. If I look at the logs of my load exporter, I can see after seeing all the collectors that are enabled, I have a message that tells me, okay, TLS is disabled and we cannot enable it on the fly. So I will need to shut down the node exporter and start it with the new configuration file, and then I should see that TLS is actually enabled. So node exporter, and there is a new web.config flag that I can just point to my web.yaml file. And now I see the message is now TLS is enabled and it cannot be disabled on the fly. So if I want to disable TLS, I need to shut it down again and to start it without a file, or with the file but without TLS configuration in it. I can also see that enabling TLS did enable HTTP2, which is supported since Prometheus 2.19, so the currently latest release. It was disabled by accident, now it's enabled again, so we will be actually be using HTTP2 to communicate between the Prometheus and the node exporter now. So let's see my Prometheus server now. First, let's see my node exporter. So this is my node exporter. Now it tells me that I am sending an HTTP request to an HTTPS server. Okay, so let's switch to HTTPS. So as a reminder, so this is a self-signed certificate which is not recognized by my browser. So advance and then accept the recent continue. So now I am over HTTPS connected to my node exporter and I can see the metrics over HTTPS. My Prometheus server now can also access the node exporter metrics. Remember that for the moment we have still enabled the option to skip the TLS verification, so any certificate will make the Prometheus server happy. But we will now copy the certificate to the public file to the Prometheus server, and so that the communication will be verified between the two of them. But currently I can already see that Prometheus is using HTTPS to communicate to the node exporter. The next step now is to enable the CA in Prometheus so that instead of just trusting that we are connected to the right server by not checking the certificate, we now check that we are connected to the correct node exporter. So the first thing that I will show you is what happens when I disable the TLS verification, the TLS skip verification. So I take my Prometheus.yaml and I just like remove my insecure skip verify and I reload my Prometheus configuration. So in a few seconds, Prometheus will scrape again with the new configuration and it will tell me, okay, the certificate is signed by an unknown authority now, which means that it doesn't know who emitted the certificate, so it cannot monitor the certificate properly. Now I have put a copy of the certificate there, and I will just like tell Prometheus that this is the CA that he should use. So I will add a new parameter, CA file, node exporter.crt, which is the path to the file. And if I reload my Prometheus configuration now, I will see in 10 seconds that now it will use that certificate authority that I've provided, which in this case is the self-signed certificate. So not the private key, but the public certificate. And now Prometheus did recognize it and he is able to verify that he is connected to the correct server. We can check in the configuration that it has taken the configuration correctly. Where is that? So insecure skip verify is false now, and the CA file is the node exporter.crt. So that's it, that's how you secure the traffic between Prometheus and the node exporter. So now Prometheus knows that he's talking to the correct node exporter. I will not today show you the client side, but it is the same principle. So if I go to the Prometheus configuration, then I can see that the TLS config contains also a cert file and a key file, which are used as client certificates. So it is the same as the other way around. So I am able to provide a certificate and a key to my Prometheus server. So it can, as a client, go to the server and say, hey, I am Prometheus. And in the node exporter, you have a client CA file that you can use and a client auth type that you need to set to verify the client. So basically, by setting, configuring the node exporter and the Prometheus server, you are able to do the same check in the other direction and ensure that only Prometheus can scrape your server. Let's now play with basic authentication. In the HTTP world, basic authentication means that when you connect to a target, you provide a username and a password, and the server will verify it. In our case, we will use the basic authentication between the Prometheus server and the target so that not everyone will be able to query the metrics, for example. So now, if I connect to my node exporter server, I can just do a curl dash k because I don't want to check the certificate, and then run 127.0.0.1. 9100 and then slash metrics, and I will see the metrics of my servers. So anyone who which has access to the server which is over the internet can see the metrics basically. We will now add a username and a password. So we are back to the documentation of the node exporter, and next to the TLS configuration, we find the basic authentication users. It is a all or nothing authentication, which means that to have access to the landing page, to the metrics page, to any of the HTTP page shared by the node exporter, you will need to be authenticated. We need a username and a password in the configuration file. So let's start and create a user that will be the admin user, so me as an admin to check the metrics locally, for example. Let's change the web.yaml and add the basic auth users and add the admin user. And then I need to specify the password. But the password is not put in plain text in the file because the node exporter doesn't really need to know the password. The password will be put in the bcrypt format, which means that when we will have a password, we will verify it against that hash and see if it matches what we expect. I will not go into the details. Again, in the configuration, we have an example to generate a bcrypt password. So let's go. I type the password and now I have it. I can just put it in the configuration. So what is happening now? My curl now says that I am unauthorized, so I cannot see the metrics. And it's not only me. So if I now go to my Prometheus server, to my target, oops, now the Prometheus itself is not authorized to scrape the metrics neither. So now if I do my curl and I actually pass the username and the password that I have chosen, so dash u admin, yeah. Now I see the metrics. So now I have added password protection to my metrics, so not anyone can see them anymore. It also means that Prometheus will not start to collect all the information to do all the scrape behind the scenes. So it's a relatively fast operation. That will not touch the external systems. It will just consume a bunch of CPU. So if I put a wrong password, I get a forbidden error which says that the password is not correct. So let's create another user for the Prometheus server. So I have another password. So as you see, once again in the file, I don't put the password. In clear text, I put the bcrypt version of the password. Well, as you have seen also, I did not reload the node exporter configuration, so it did read the file again, and now it's forbidden the access if you don't have the correct password. So no need to reload the configuration, that will work directly. Now the authentication must be enabled on the Prometheus side. So I have created a file with the password, which is called node exporter password, which contains the password that I need to use to connect to my node exporter. You can choose to put the file in the password in a file separated from the prometheus.yaml, which means that every time you will change the file, you don't need to reload the Prometheus configuration to read the new password, or you can put the password directly in the Prometheus configuration. And now it is simple. Next to my TLS configuration, I will add a basic auth and say that the username is Prometheus and that the password file is node exporter password. So in this case, at every request that Prometheus will make to the node exporter, it will read the password from that file and use it to connect to the node exporter. Let's reload the Prometheus configuration to take that new basic auth into account. And now, if I am back to my Prometheus server and I wait like 10 seconds, I should see that the script now is successful again. So now my Prometheus server is connecting to the node exporter with HTTPS. So on the line, you cannot see the request and the replies, and also with a password, which means that if I now try to access my node exporter, now I am asked for a password, so I cannot see the metrics like I want. And if I put a bad password, I have forbidden. Some last words about TLS and Prometheus now. So what you have seen today with the node exporter version 1.0.0 will be extended in the future to all the projects inside the Prometheus ecosystem. As of today, we have an up-to-date security model page on the Prometheus website. If you go to the documentation, operating and security, when you can read about the future plans that we have, but also how you can report a security vulnerability. You can also find about why we choose certain defaults, like for example, by default, we only allow TLS 1.2 and 1.3. So please go read that documentation if you are curious about what the future will hold for Prometheus and security in general. And for now, I hope that you will enjoy the new TLS feature that will come, I hope still this year, into the different exporters that we have, and that you will help us grow in that direction too, in more security inside the Prometheus ecosystem and making scraping over HTTPS a reality. Thank you. So I am Gina. It was Gina Pivotto from the Prometheus team. I work at Inuit, and I presented you today Prometheus and TLS. And bye. Hello, so that was basically my talk about Prometheus and TLS, and now we will handle a Q&A session.
If there's
Participants in the webinar can look at the bottom, and at the bottom of Zoom, there's a menu that says Q&A. Please feel free to type your questions in there for Julian.
And while we're waiting, what's your thinking about different versions of TLS and what version can be used in which specific parts of the whole stack?
So I think that you should keep with the default that we provide so that in the future when we will make those default evolves, you will also follow that. And I think that we have chosen same default. So that was a discussion that happened that was not that easy, but we make the choice to support 1.2 by default, which I think is the minimum today. And that, I mean, if it is to use 1.0 and 1.1, why don't just you keep plaintext HTTP just like it existed before? So we are kind of late in the TLS game. It's nice that we are there. And it also means that we can make some choices around that that will not break users because it's the first time we do that. I see a question. So is anyone else speaking? Because I don't hear you. No.
You just read them out and take them.
What's the performance impact of TLS? So TLS does not have a big impact in itself, especially since when you enable TLS, you also have HTTP2 support. So the impact is actually regarding all the work that the exporter has to do, which is multiple seconds. Almost the exporter takes multiple thousands of milliseconds. It's not really a big impact. The impact is more if you decide to use basic authentication in Bcrypt that can take more time because you have a level of hashing in Bcrypt that can take some time and you will use that time on every request. So Bcrypt can have a different impact. So it is preferable to use generally client authentication over TLS, which will be more efficient than basic authentication. The second question we have from David is there a way, even if it takes several steps, to go from HTTP-based to HTTPS TLS-based without losing the script connectivity? Yes, it is possible, more or less. So the thing is that you would need to, per target, by using service discovery, to mark the target as HTTPS-ready in using the scheme tag, so you can apply a scheme label to your target, so __scheme, I think. If you set that to HTTPS, only that target will be using HTTPS in your job. So if you have 100 exporters and you can say, okay, I will roll out that one now, then by just adding to that one in the service discovery or with the relabeling the HTTPS feature, then you can not have a gap or just maybe one scrape if you are unlucky, but you can decide to just like for one target to use HTTPS and you can do a rollout like that. That's not an issue. Another thing you can do is to have two different jobs and to filter the targets for each job and override the job label on those sub-job, one which should be TLS based and the other one should not be TLS based. You just need to make sure that the target will not be in both jobs at the same time. But yes, there are options to do that. So I can also tell you that it's not a secret that a few years ago, Prometheus was under review by a third-party security company, and the review is public. So that previous security review is public on the Prometheus website. And we are now getting another security review for the node exporter, which includes that TLS part. And once that review is complete, we will start to roll that out to the other project of the Prometheus ecosystem. So that is coming out really soon now.
That should actually, we should already have it, but we don't yet, but like next week it should actually be published. That's at least the timeline which we got. So, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I dare say a lot of attendees learned quite a bit from this.